Hello. This is our fifth week of our music lessons on the internet. So we're going to start in the way that we usually start, and I'll get myself comfy and we go. Hello to you. Move your shoulders, 1, 2. Now stamp your feet and clap to the beat. Wave your hands up high. Point your fingers to the sky with a smile and a grin. Turn round and spin. Well done, everyone. Now our lesson has begun. Well done. Are we all ready? So for the last few weeks, we've been doing the rhythm of what's for tea today. So let's just remind ourselves of how that goes. So there's a my bit and a your bit. I'll clap the rhythm of your bit, but you've got to try and remember the words. But remember, if I go, what's for tea today, you say cold fish fingers. Then if I go, what's for tea today, it's chicken and chips. And then with the macaroni, 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 cheese is your bit. Okay, but can we do it with clapping the rhythm today? So I'll start. What's for tea today? What's for tea today? What's for tea today? What's for tea today? Macaroni, macaroni, macaroni. Macaroni, macaroni, macaroni. Macaroni, macaroni, macaroni. Macaroni, macaroni, macaroni. What's for tea today? What's for tea today? What's for tea today? What's for tea today? Well done. So let's do it now without the words and just clapping the rhythms. Okay, I'm going to clap your rhythm with you, but you're going to say the words in your head, not actually say them out loud. So I'm going to start, but I will mouth the words just to help you. So here we go. Well done. Did you get through that? Did you manage to get your bits in time? We're going to do it one more time. I'm not going to mouth the words this time. I'm just going to clap my rhythms, but I'm not going to clap yours. You've got to get yours in yourself. Are you ready? Off we go. Well done. Did you get all of your rhythms in? Did you remember it all? Really good. I bet your fingers are tingling now. Mine certainly are. Shall we go over our song Calypso? We're going to use it a couple of times today. So if I play the accompaniment and you sing the song with me, okay? I'm going to just do a little introduction and then sing your song. Go. Anytime you need a calypso, here is what you must do. First of all, you need a rhythm, so shake a little, shake a little, shake a little, shake it, and you bang a drum, and you sing and strum, and then there's a calypso for you. Well done. Let's put put in a bit more rhythm now. Have you got any percussion instruments that you want to add? You ready? Here's your introduction. Anytime you need a calypso, here is what you must do. First of all, you need a rhythm, so shake a little, shake a little, shake a little, shake a little. Come back to that later on. So we've been also looking at rhythms, rhythms all the time, but it's a matter of how do we write rhythms. So I'm going to share a screen with you, and here we are. Let me make that a little bit bigger. So we've got our crotchets, our tar, we've got our quavers, our titis, and our rests, a shh. Okay, so if I move these out of the way, then I can make some rhythms up. So I'm just going to make some rhythms here. Let's put them in a line. So what have we got there? We've got four crotchets. Can you clap those four crotchets for me? And it's ta, 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 ta. Did you get that? Let's do that again. Ready, go. Ta, 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 ta. Brilliant. Now I'm going to change that a little bit. So if we get that one out of the way, put that in there. Okay, can you clap that rhythm for me? Yes, it goes ta, ta, ti, ti, ta. Shall we do it together? Ready, go. Ta, ta, ti, ti, ta. Okay, if I move that one out of the way, move that one over there. Have you practiced writing these rhythms? Have you practiced writing these notes, in fact? So now we've got a crotchet, two quavers, a rest and a crotchet. Can you clap that rhythm for me? Yes, it goes ta, ti, ti, sh, ta. Shall we try it together? Ta, ti, ti, sh, ta. Okay, so you're getting really good at doing those now. So I'm just going to stop sharing that screen with you and we're going to play a game. I'm going to share another screen with you. If I can find it, here we go. Right, so we've got four notes there. I've got four different screens on the left hand side of the picture. So can you clap that rhythm for me? Are you ready? Ta, 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 ta. Well done. I'm going to change now to that rhythm. Can you clap that one for me? Well done. It goes ta, ti, ti, ta, ta. Well done. Let's do that one and then do that one straight away. Are you ready? I'm going to tap my knee. I can't clap because I'm using the mouse. So this one first, ready and go now. Ta, 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 ti, ti, ta, ta. Did you manage to move from one to the other? Let's do page one first again. Ready and go now. Ta, 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 ti, ti, ta, ta. Well done. Let's have a look at this one. Can you clap that one for me? Okay, that one goes ta, sh, T T T T. Did you get that? Shall we try it? Ta sh T T T T. Well done. And now let's look at the last one. Ta 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 sh. Did you get that? Shall we do it together again? Ta 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 sh. Right, let's do this one. This is number 3 and number 4 straight after each other. You ready? Ready? Go. Ta sh t t t t ta 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 sh. Let's practice that again. Are you ready? Off we go now. Ta sh t t t t ta 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 sh. Okay. Right. Let's go from number 1 and see if we can go all the way down to number 4 without stopping. Are you ready? Off we go now. Ta 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 ti ti ta 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 sh ti 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 ta 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 sh. Did you manage that? Was that a bit quick? Should we go a bit slower this time? Ready and go now. Ta 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 ti ti ta 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 sh ti 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 ta 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 sh. Well done. Right, I'm going to hide one of these now, but you've still got to remember it. So if I go back to the first one, and if I get rid of these, hang on a minute, let me do it. Okay, so we've still got to remember it though. Are you ready? Off we go now. Ta 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 ti ti ta 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 sh ti 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 ta 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 sh. Did you remember all of that? Right, this time I'm going to get rid of these at the end. Do you think you'll be able to remember that? So we're going to start with the first one. Can you remember what that one was? Okay, here we go. Off we go now. Ta 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 ti ti ta 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 sh ti 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 ta sh. Oh, ta 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 sh. I nearly got that one wrong, didn't I? Should we try that one again? So we start with number 1. We've got to remember this one. Ready and go now. Ta 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 ti ti ta 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 sh ti 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 ta 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 sh. Did you remember those? Which one shall I get rid of now? Shall I get rid of this one? Well, I hope I can remember. Okay, are we ready? Start with number 1. Can you remember the second one? I hope I can. Off we go now. Ta 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 ti ti ta 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 sh ti 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 ta 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 sh. Ooh. Shall I get rid of all of these now? Let's see if we can remember the whole lot. Not sure I can. Are you ready? Off we go now. Ta 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 ti ti ta 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 sh ti 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 ta 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 sh. Did you remember them all? Shall we just do it once more? Ready? Off we go now. Ta 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 ti ti ta 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 sh ti 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 ta 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 sh. Well done if you remembered all of that. If you get stuck, you can always stop the video and go back over it. Let's see if we got all of those right, shall we? Let's see. I'll put them all back now. There we are. There they all are. Shall we do it one more time? Ready? One, two, three, go. ta 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 ti ti ta 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 sh ti 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 ta 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 sh. Well done. Did you remember all of that? I'm just going to stop sharing that screen now. So you're getting really good at reading proper notation there. So you know crotchets, you know quavers, and you know rests. Now I was wondering whether any of you had instruments at home. Some of you might have ukuleles. Some of you might have keyboards. I'm not sure what you might have. If you haven't got a keyboard, you could probably download onto your iPads a virtual keyboard. I've got my own keyboard here. And I thought that I could just teach you an accompaniment to go with the calypso, so that if you rewind the video, you can actually play along with the calypso, not just doing it with percussion instruments. You could probably use some other instruments as well. So the notes that you would need, I'm just going to share that screen for you. Let's see if we can get this. There we go. So the notes that are important are D, G, A and D, and that's just a little sequence. Now if I just, I'm going to stop sharing that screen with you a minute. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to show you is on the ukulele. Now I'm not very good at the ukulele, I can play it a little bit. So there is the chord of D, so that is three fingers like that on the top three strings, and then the chord of G. Can you remember in that sequence there was D, then G, and then it was A, but I'm going to use a simplified version of A, which is that one, and then we go back to D again. Okay, so we could do our song using that. So we've got D, and we could do four of those. We could do four D's and then four G's. I'm not very good at changing there. I need to practice. Four G's, four A's. In fact, that's an A seventh. And then four D's again. Do you want to sing through with me while I'm playing? Yeah? Are you ready? So this is our calypso song. Anytime you need a calypso, good, but at least I'm having a go. Some of you might have a ukulele at home, so you can have a go at doing that. Now the other way we could do it, we could actually use our keyboards. And I said, if you download a virtual keyboard from the internet, it will probably it'll probably have the notes written on the keyboard as well. So if we got a D is just between two black notes, so you could do four D's. You could go D, 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 then four G's, because I said it was D, G, G, then A, and then D again. So we've got D, G, A, D, and four of each. So we'll do that again. D, 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 G, 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 A, 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 D, 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 D. So as I say, if you download a virtual keyboard, and then you can play this on your iPads or even your phones or even on your computer, however way you are, you can use it. So let's just try that. So if I was to do it down here, we can sing our song. Anytime you need a calypso, here is what you must do. Shake a little, shake, and you're back. Let me just share that screen with you again so that you can see those notes. There we go. So you've got a sequence of D's, G, A, and D. So you do lots of D's, lots of G's, lots of A's, and then back to D's again. So I'm just going to sing the song again, and then you can see how this works. So we start with D. Anytime you need a calypso, here is what you must do. First of all, you need a rhythm, so shake a little, shake a little, shake a little, shake it, and you bang a drum, and you sing and strum, and then there's a calypso for you. Well done. So that is a bit of a repeated pattern, isn't it? A repeated pattern. You could change it. Instead of doing four D's, four G's, four A's and four D's, you could do another rhythm. So you could do a rhythm with three D's, but make a first one a longer one. D, 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 G, 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 A, 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 D. So that's a slightly different rhythm. So again, you're doing a repeated pattern, but with a longer note to start off with. So that's again something that you could do on a virtual keyboard. That would be really good fun. Okay, I'm just going to play it through twice more so that you can play along if you get a keyboard. So you can pause your video, download or get your virtual keyboard or a ukulele or something. So here we go. This is an introduction. Just going to stop sharing that screen. So you could do a repeated pattern there. You could actually have done a repeated pattern using your percussion instruments as well. So the word for a repeated pattern is an ostinato. An ostinato. So let me see if I can draw that for you. So if I share a whiteboard with you, and let's see if I can draw the word. This is funny. Nah. There you go, ostinato. So an ostinato is a repeated pattern. An ostinato is a repeated pattern. So if you're doing a repeated pattern with your percussion instruments, or if indeed you did choose to do those notes on a keyboard or on a ukulele or something, it's called an ostinato, a repeated pattern. So well done for that. So we've talked about quite a few things there, haven't we? So we've talked about accompanying things using an ostinato. We've been doing rhythms. We've been clapping different rhythms. We're going to go towards the end of our lesson now by listening to a piece of music. And the focus word here is pitch. So pitch is something to do when something is really, really high or very, very low or everything in between. So when we sing, we change the pitch of our voice. Sometimes our notes go up, our voices go up, sometimes our notes go down. That is a change in pitch. So going higher in pitch and lower in pitch. Nothing to do with loudness and quietness, that's dynamics. So we're talking about pitch. So we're going to listen to a piece of music now called Tuba Smarties. It's a bit of a fun piece and it was written in the 1970s and the featuring instrument is a tuba. Now a tuba, well, I'm going to see what you think. Is it a low-pitched instrument or a high-pitched instrument? So I'm just going to share my screen again. So here we go. Well, what did you think to that? Did you like that? How did that make you feel? I feel quite joyous when I'm listening to music like that, because it's quite jolly. So as I say, we were talking about pitch, and the fact there that the tuba there, that instrument there, is a very big instrument. It's a brass instrument. In fact, all of these instruments are brass instruments, and that is a low-pitched brass instrument. It was really, really low. Now I'm just going to go back a little bit and let's see if we can see some of the other instruments there. So it was mainly him. There's some more tubas there. There were quite a few in the band, but also there were, let's see if we can find them here. So these instruments are a lot smaller. They're still brass instruments, and these are trumpets. I know the quality of this video wasn't particularly brilliant. It was taken quite a few years ago, in the 1970s, as I said. So where the instrument is a lot smaller, the pitch of these instruments is high. It's high pitch, whereas the tuba, which is a really big instrument there, can you see how big it is? So that's a really big instrument. That is a low pitched instrument. And can you see there's all of these tubes here? And if all those tubes were unraveled and instead of being all curled up, and if they were all in one line, that tube would be quite long. So again, that is why it's a low pitched instrument. But if we were go back again and have a look at those trumpets, there are tubes there, all curled up, but if they were to be unravelled, they certainly wouldn't be as long as the tuba. So that is, again, they're smaller, so therefore they are more high pitch. Right, I'm just going to stop sharing that screen. So we've talked about quite a few things there, haven't we? We've talked about pitch, where something is high pitch and something is low pitch. It might be our voices, it might be things that we hear outside. Birds tweeting a high pitch sound, whereas an engine is often a low pitch sound, isn't it? And in those instruments, the tuba is certainly a lower pitched instrument against the trumpet, even though they are all brass instruments. Then what was that other word that we used for a repeated pattern? The word beginning with O, it was ostinato. So ostinato is a repeated pattern, and you can use an ostinato to accompany a piece of music. Okay, all that remains for me to say is thank you very much and goodbye.